Welcome, we'll go over the concepts of grids, sources, and the hue, saturation and intensity color model. Let's start by adding 4 RGB lights. We'll use the generic RGB fixture, which works with a wide range of fixtures. Let's add the 4 lights and use the default settings. All RGB lights are controlled via the hue, saturation, and intensity, lightness, attributes. It's easier to create color effects this way, and it allows to seamlessly work with all RGB variations like RGBW, RGBA, RGBA, etc. To control an attribute, you select it in the list and put it on the grid. Hold the Control key while clicking attributes in the list. Then press and hold the mouse button to put them on the grid. Let's open the grid monitor to see a preview of the lights. It's all black. We need to add a source to send power to the attributes. That's how we control them. Here's our first source. It has many parameters, allowing to customize your effect. The power is the most basic parameter. Think of a source as a power emitter. You can move it around, it also can move automatically. The range determines how far the power goes. This allows creating gradient and fan effects. All sliders can be linked to a generator and one of the many inputs. The delay determines how fast the power wave is moving around. The emitting direction is also fully configurable, allowing to target only some attributes on the grid. Positioning your source differently gives you different effects. You can also position the attributes differently to achieve the effect you want. You can flip and rotate the attributes to ease creating your effect. No need to position attributes like they are in reality. For more precise control over the attributes, you can remap the source's power. Use the min and max control, click in the middle to set both the min and max. Click on the left to set the min, click on the right to set the max. Right-click on the middle to move the range. Right-click on the left or right to preview setting the min or max. Use as many sources as you want. The power of all sources are added. Let's copy the source to generate different intensities. All wave generators are synced, so if we reset the time, we'll end up with the same sine wave. To add some diversity, We'll select all sources and link the power to a random wave. Now it's more interesting. Even more interesting, let's add some color by using the hue and saturation attributes. Tip: filter the attribute list by typing keywords. Then we put the hue attributes on the grid by pressing and holding the mouse button. Do the same for the saturation attributes. Why is the monitor showing multiple times the same lights? It's because it shows one square per attribute. We'll create a dedicated grid for the monitor to show the lights as they are in reality. The attribute you use to represent a light doesn't matter. We'll use the saturation attributes. Delete the source since we don't want to control the saturations. Now we have a monitor giving a preview of the lights as they are in the real world. Let's go back to our effect. We're ready to control the hue and saturation attributes. Right now, no source is sending power to them, so they are inactive even though they are on a grid. Let's add a source. The hue is circular, starting from red. The source's parameters as seen before can all be used to control the hue attributes. Generators can be used. Use the delay to create a color scroll. And use the range to create gradients. The hue attributes, as all attribute types, can remap the source's power. Finally, we'll copy a source to control the saturation attributes, CTRL-C to copy and CTRL-V to paste. Click the hand button to unlink a slider from a generator. (0% saturation is gray and 100% is the fully saturated hue. And that's just the beginning. Enjoy!